Do you do any kind of meditation? This is something I always wonder. Or prayer or anything like that?
No, meditation. No. At the end of the day, just a good, my good meditation is a glass of Jack Daniels, you know. This is
Nice.
my style of meditation.
You don't have to learn to trade alone. Welcome to the Trading Lifestyle Podcast, where we interview professional currency traders and industry experts who can help you improve your trading and your life. And now, your host, Hugh Kimura.
Hello, traders, and welcome to episode number 17 of the Trading Lifestyle Podcast. My name is Hugh Kimura, and in this episode, I was really fortunate to be able to interview Walter Vanelli. He's an independent trader in Italy, and he got started at the back office of a bank. And there were some events where they were a little short-staffed, and somehow he ended up on the dealing desk. And from there, he just kind of fell in love with it. He got to see the behind-the-scenes action and how trades really work from the bank's perspective. So I think that's really valuable information. And he shares a little bit of that with us. From there, he went on to trade for himself. He also consulted with other banks on how to set up their back office and their accounting because his experience was pretty unique at that point because forex trading or retail forex trading was just getting started. So he really did have a leg up on the competition. So I think you'll really like what he has to say. Just a word of warning before we begin. Walter apologized because his English is a little rusty. So if you have a hard time understanding him at certain points, just stick with it because he does get into some great information, especially towards the end. So I hope you enjoy this interview. And if you really like it, I would appreciate an honest review on iTunes. Before we get started, I know you've heard this before, but I have to say this. This podcast is for educational and entertainment purposes only and is not investment, trading, or financial advice of any kind. But in this episode, there might be some advice on how to comb your mustache. As you know, Forex or any type of trading is very risky and you could lose all of your money. Seriously. And finally, past performance does not indicate future results. All right, now on to the show.
Hi, Walter. Thank you for taking the time out. I really appreciate it.
Hi, thank you very much to you.
So how did you first get interested in trading?
Well, I started from the, well, honestly, I started in a bank office. Mm-hmm. And after 1 year, I'm talking about 1982, the bank gave me the opportunity to switch to the dealing room in charge of position keeper, of course. Mm-hmm. but it was just luck. Because they were a shortage of staff. Mm-hmm. But after all, now I can say it was a good business for both. You know, on the first day that I was in a dealing room, I say, wow, I won't do that. That was my first day in the dealing room, 1982.
Wow.
That was just a case, you know.
Yeah.
I worked for the was at the end of the story was really helpful for me to see the accounting, to see what there is behind
mm-hmm, kind
the trading. Yes, it's very important. Yes, and is useful for me as well now.
Ah, I see. Very cool. So I was looking at your resume, and from there you kind of went on to some other banks, and you worked in the treasury and FX departments. Did you study that in college, or did you something unrelated?
Yes, my study, I have a normal degree in economics and accounting, and helped me, of course, but the passion did the rest. Mm-hmm. After all, you know, Forex is a passion.
It's,
first of all, yes.
Uh-huh.
Because you can trade and stocks for stocks or bonds, but Forex especially is a passion, you know.
Oh, yeah, it's really good to. I mean, it's very important to trade what you like, right?
Yeah.
Okay, very cool. Like you were saying, you're involved in Forex since the early 80s. And I was wondering, has anything really changed in terms of how the banks trade after Forex became popular with the retail traders?
We can say that the foreign exchange market was a little known, especially in Italy, I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. Was only known by big companies and investment funds, of course. Mm-hmm. Those that the banks call big customer, that's what I mean. But okay. Outside was real different. Mm-hmm. The rise of the retail market that was thanks to the possibility of the leverage. Mm-hmm. So this the retails gave a chance of business prior to the broker, then to the bank, to increase their earnings. Mm-hmm. Now, however, I would like to say that market for retail already exists since 1997. Mm-hmm. But it was much more expensive because first of all, the leverage was maximum 20 leverage.
Oh, okay.
Minimum capital deposit was $25,000.
Oh, wow.
And minimum amount for size that you have each deals, I mean, was $250,000 minimum amount that you can trade. Mm-hmm. For a cost for each trade of $15.
Wow.
So was not for all, as we used to say.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, banks and brokerage house still following this kind of market since 1995.
Mm-hmm. I see. Has it changed the way?
In the platform and first of all, the leverage, the possibility to work with a high leverage, so you can open an account with $1,000 or $2,000. You know.
Yeah.
But the leverage and the platform boost immediately the market, and especially that the platform keep your accounting, because in the 1997 you can I dealt in 1997 by myself,
mm-hmm.
but you can deal only by phone, you know, and you have to pay if you work from home, for example, because we were studying about that. If you work as a professional trader but alone,
mm-hmm.
you have to pay minimum other $3,000 per year for a provider that gives you the real time price. That's
oh, wow.
So yes, was completely. So you can imagine the platform boost this market. Now everybody got this forex frenzy, as I used to say.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
yeah.
That's what happened. That's what I think about the retail. And first of all for the brokerage house, and second for the bank, was a good new opportunity to earn money.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Okay, interesting.
Man, that's good.
So I was looking at your resume again, and I guess in 2003 you decided to leave ICM Forex and go out on your own to consult. What made you leave?
I leave because they closed their activity.
Oh, okay. Okay, that's a good reason.
That's a good reason. And they sold all the platform and all the study that we have done,
mm-hmm.
to the brokerage house in London.
Okay.
So, the worst investment in my life, and you know what I mean.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes, okay. But so, that's life. Can happen, you know.
Yeah, yeah. So why not go back to another job? Why did you decide to go out on your own?
Well, because, you know, first of all, I think that Forex is my job.
Mm-hmm.
It's all I have done in my life.
Uh-huh.
all the rest I'm a disaster, you know. But the only things I know is a Forex. So I was as well consulting, of course, for private and investments house about the accounting mm-hmm. programs before I know what exactly happened after a deal. Mm-hmm. And you have to account the deal, you have to move the confirmation, and especially the law that there is, for example, in Italy in matter of Forex trading. So what was good, because I had some clients, and I have some private clients that one wouldn't start to trade mm-hmm. in the market, but you know, they used to trade in a stocks exchange, but they never tried to trade in Forex. Yeah, of course. So as I have done in my life with the professional traders in a bank for the beginners, I mean, I have a method to explain how is the market, how you can trade. I have the right method, and so I start to open a consulting office for course of trading. And consulting for investment house about trading, you know, mm-hmm. or as well for import, export company.
Oh, nice. Yes. Okay.
Then, but arrived the when arrived the crisis arrives immediately. So.
Okay.
Okay. Stop loss. No. Stop loss.
So I guess in 2006, you decided to kind of do consulting and trading. Is that correct?
Yes, yes. Combination of consulting and trading. It depends, you know. Well, I always trade by myself since mm-hmm. 2003 in a different site, because we in that period, so between 2000 and 2003, we were starting in a good platform, and the accounting, so I was in charge of supervisor to work with, first of all, with the programmers that works on the software for the accounting, and as well for the programmers that could build and something like MetaTrader 4, you know. Mm. So you have the price and you can sell or buy. That's what I've done, in ICM. But in 2006, I started trading because, well, I started trading by myself mm-hmm. again with another account company in Italy. And meanwhile, when I had some customer, I used to be on his disposition for every kind of advisor in for an exchange. Mm-hmm. So. That's all.
Oh, I see. Okay. That's great. How long did it take you to become a consistently profitable trader?
Well, okay. That's good. A really good question. Because, as I said, we studied this possibility. So in 1997, in 1997, I tried to have a simulation training with a private company in Italy that want to work with the retired traders. Mm-hmm. No? And so we understand that there is one common problem that the expert trader or beginner trader working on daily, I mean, attention, pay attention, daily activity, mm-hmm. you know, mm-hmm. they lose more.
Okay.
Yes. So the real question was, why?
Uh-huh.
Because you can, the techniques of trading We know the techniques of trading. So what is the problem, you know? So I divided the problem between long-term position mm-hmm. and daily. Mm-hmm. I understand that in daily trading, okay, you have to work outside the trading range mm-hmm. because if you work by yourself, you don't know what's up in the real market. Mm-hmm. So if you buy or sell, maybe a good idea. But if you put, for example, a stop loss in 30 pips for a trade, 30, 50 pips, maybe the market could trigger your stop loss because, for example, you long mm-hmm. at one price in the middle of the trading range and a bank have a customer order of 200 or 300 million euro, mm-hmm. market down, maybe after gonna be up again, mm-hmm. but for coming down, you see 30, 35 pips and you close your deal. So, and you lose, you fire it. Mm-hmm. That's what this the problem. So I think, I start to wonder why this was possible. Mm-hmm. So to study the difference, to using the same experience, there was two trading in a dealer room and by yourself. Results, no works in a trading range, first of all, without cost, if you do not have a customer. That's what I mean. Because if you have a customer, okay, it's easy money. A customer want to buy at 40, 131 and 90 euro dollar, you find the 131.88 on the market, 88 mine, 90 yards, two pips or thread, mine, easy money. That's what the banks do. But you are not a bank. Mm-hmm. So, you, as we used to say in Italy, you have a few bullets in your gun. So, take care if you have just a few bullets in your gun. Mm-hmm. So, then I started to play with a virtual account in simulation. Okay. So, I adapted my experience under a new condition, and it's work.
Okay.
And after 2 or 3 months, I saw that you can have a result if you're going to trade for 10, 20, or 25 pips, okay? Mm-hmm. Because what I have done, I limited the risk. Because if you work outside the range, the only risk that you have is that the price back in a range. So just a few pips. Because mm-hmm. if you buy, for example, outside the top of the range at the moment is 131.90. You buy at 139.91 if confirmed signal, you know? Mm-hmm. What is the risk? The risk is the market back to 88, 85, 87. Okay, if the market back closed, what is your loss? 5, 6 pip. Mm-hmm. So you reduce the risk. So when you start to trade by yourself, the first things that you have to learn is how to manage the risk. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Then you can take the risk, and then you can trade. Mm-hmm. That's no before to trade, do the opposite. Before you trade, and then you're, okay, what am I going to do now? Where I put the stop loss? No. First of all, you have to minimize your risk. Mm-hmm. That's what I've done.
Oh, I see. Okay, so you're basically trading when price leaves the trading range, right?
Yes, right.
Okay, very cool. And about how long did you take to figure out the system?
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. That's what I do. What I've done today, mm-hmm. for example, the market was paid above 91. At 92, I was long. I saw 132.06 yards immediately. Mm-hmm. Take 14 pips. That's good for a day. And close it. Then the market bounced back at 87 in 10 minutes. Mm-hmm. That's what's good for me because it works. The only problem that you can have, the only risk that you can have is the false signal. But the false signal might be a cost for you as a private trader of 4 or 5 tips. Depend on you, of course.
Yeah.
You can stay open till 2025, but it's useless if the price back in the range. That's what I mean. Wow. So discipline and cost entry. The price back in a range, closed. That's it. That's the low.
I see. Okay. Can you give us an idea of your trading routine every day? Is there a routine that you go through? Do you get up early? Do you get up late? What do you do?
He's a 30 year that I have the same routine. You know, I woke up early. I mean, 7:30 in the morning, you know. And I studied the market with my first cup of coffee, you know. And I studied the market, and I dedicated the mass no more than 10 minutes each day for charts.
Okay.
Because I am afraid I can't invest and waste my time all the day with the charts and study the charts, you know. So I prefer read some paper, economic paper, some news on the web about market. Then I study what the daily calendar for news, if there is a day with news or without news. Then finally I study what's up in the Far East mass market.
Okay.
And just I start to understand what might be the range when the market opened. Then I start with my trading activity.
I see. About how long do you spend actually trading?
Can you repeat, please? Because I can't hear you so well. So.
Oh, okay. Sorry. Sure.
No, don't worry. I have a problem on my handcuff. Sorry.
No, that's okay. About how long do you actually spend trading? Is it like an hour or 2 hours, or is it throughout the day?
I stay all the day on the online with the trading. But like in the office, from the night in the morning to the 6 in the afternoon. But okay, if I have to close because I have a meeting or consulting, I close, of course. So at the end of the story is full time for 6-7 hours a day if the market is not so boring like yesterday or the day before. But that's what I do.
Okay, interesting. What are your biggest strengths and weaknesses as a trader?
Well, this is a good question because, I have nothing them in the both parts, no strengths and weakness. All that I have done is the first of all, I fight with the best enemy of the trader. The first enemy of the trader is himself. When you're in peace with yourself, you have no more weakness in the market. And first of all, as I used to say during the trading classroom, I used to say that to be a trader, you need just one thing for first, discipline, discipline. And I still discipline. This is could be my strength, of course. Weakness, no, because, I can't tell you, yes, probably for the reason if I am not so passionate with the economists, but like every traders, you know, economics and trader, because it was the usually polemics that the economy spent is time to talk, the traders have to do. This is the difference. So maybe my weakness is that I don't spend so many time to look in charts.
Okay. That's a good answer. I like the part about being at peace with yourself.
Yes, that's true. Because I used to say that the best enemy of the trader is yourself. That's true, because especially when you are near the stop loss and you move the stop loss.
Yeah.
Instead of loss, this is your enemy, the enemy inside you. Or when you lose the money, you say, I wanna earn now immediately. No, maybe you have to split your lose in 2 or 3 days, and take it easy. That's why. But it's more for experience, you know.
Yeah.
Because all that beginner or a beginner can feel. All that I can be a beginner can feel. I mean, frustrated, or depression, or fury. I have had in my life. So after 32 years, I have a bit wisdom approach with Mark. You know.
Okay. Well, you talked about discipline. Is journaling part of that? Do you journal your trades? How do you keep track of what you're doing right and what you're doing wrong?
Well, I am terrible, sorry, but I never do something like that.
Okay.
As a trader. And right now, I don't do. But okay, I know a couple of my old people that I follow for tutoring do that. And then I say, okay, if it's better for you, do that, okay? I never do that because in a bank it's impossible. I suppose with the chaos in a bank, you say, a moment, I have to update my journal. You fire it up in a second. You know?
Yeah. Okay. Oh, I see. Okay. It's always good to hear what people have to say, and I think that works for some people and it doesn't work for other people. So that's very interesting. Who have been some of your trading heroes? Have you looked up to certain people? Have you had mentors that really helped you along?
Well, I don't have heroes in particular, but I have known excellent traders during my career. Maybe to our times. Talking about more than 20 years ago, we were everybody saw George Soros like a sort of guru. You know, for us was the number one. So maybe George Soros, of course, but without trader, never see something like heroes. And I hope nobody see me like an heiress, because I'm not an heiress. I'm only a trader. Yeah.
That's a very grounded approach to take to that. Very cool. Okay, so I kind of wanted to get into your training and how you teach other traders. I guess you've worked at a lot of banks, obviously, including Citibank. What was the number one thing that retail trader? Well, I guess you went into this about the trading range, right? Like traders need to know that the banks kind of pick off your orders in the trading range. Is there anything else that they need to know?
Well, there is, well, first of all, the most important thing that everybody have to know is the difference of the amount that we use in a dealing room, respect to one lot or two micro lot or three lots that you, or 1 million that you can do. Personally, I had a rollover about 500 and $600 million each day with trading. So you know what I mean. So first of all, respect the market. Never go against the market. Remember, the market, we in the market, we scared as well the central banks. So first of all, don't do that. Second, may I suggest, every bank, so as well, big banks, so everybody talk about market, they give your, like, they gave you a rumors possibility, but we have, I always say, listen, anyone, trust No one. That's lesson number one.
Okay, I see.
That's okay.
Good. So I guess this is kind of related. Some people say that, okay, you know, trading is fixed and you can't make money in Forex because of the banks and all that stuff. What do you tell those people?
Well, about bank and brokers, you mean?
Yeah, they're trading against you and stuff like
well,
that.
If I have to speak about my experience, I say that yes, mm-hmm. as a sort of gentleman agreement. Trigger the stop loss sometimes is a normal sport, mm-hmm. easy money. So it's very, very easy if you are a big bank, in agreement with another bank in a brokerage house and say, where the stop loss are? The stop loss are 132. Okay, mm-hmm. euro dollar now see 132, 10, 12. Nobody touch you. Mm-hmm. You can be sure. So you trick stop loss easy money because I'm sorry you were stopped loss.
Yeah.
Is not nothing personal. It's just a question of business.
Okay.
That's hard, but that's true. You know.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. So, but as long as you know that they're, I guess they can only move the market so much, though, right? They can't control it for a long period of time, but they can take out those small stop losses. Is that correct?
Yeah. Yes. Yes. Okay. Yes. Of course.
I see. Okay. That's good to know. we're talking about how these banks have these advantages. What are some advantages that the retail traders have?
Just a word, money. Money and is a good window of dressing for the banks.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, behind the major brokerage providers, there are the best bank in the Forex market. I mean, UBS, Deutsche Bank, Hong Kong Shine Banking Corporation, Citibank, Commerce Bank.
Mm-hmm.
There's a good window dress, is good for windows dressing and money, of course, because the brokerage house have to cover their amount of exposition with the banks
mm-hmm.
for love, you know. That's good. It's another good opportunity, as I say, to earn money.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Through the spread, yes.
All right. Okay. How do you teach people? Do you just put them into the market, or do you make them back test, or how do you go about that?
Well, I can say that I'm so proud about that because with a beginner trader in a bank and private trader now, I never failure a mission because as I say before, I have a medium to explain in easy. So I used to repeat the same thing till I'm not sure that you really understand. because I used to say, ask if you don't understand.
Uh-huh.
I repeat. I never be tired to repeat. Because it's important that you repeat where I prefer someone that tell me I don't understand. Can you repeat? Because I don't understand how I have to trade in this case. What is the confirmation signal? I prefer than a person that say, yes, I understand, and they didn't understand. Because I love to protect the people that try to learn, and I respect, first of all. So I'm talking about a backtesting. I can say that I never fail you because as well now online on Twitter I have a few person that learn to teach from me and I see that they now makes money.
Mm-hmm.
That's good for me, you know. Mm-hmm. Because finally I think I'm proud about that. Because I know a lot of big traders that told me, Walter, are you so patient? I honestly, I don't care. If you done nothing about Forex, it's not my problem.
Mm-hmm.
Then it's a different mind, you know. I always liked about that, because the first time that I teach someone was in BNA in 1990.
Uh-huh.
First time I learned to the couple of guys that we takes in charge of spot trader.
Mm-hmm. I see. Okay, so your trading style is more like repetition and just having them go through it day by day and have them ask you questions and.
Mm.
Okay, that's great. what are some of your favorite trading books, or maybe even non-trading books?
I never read trading books. I'm sorry.
Oh, okay.
For the rest, I love and I'm an avid reader about philosophy.
Okay.
I mean, a great thinker. I am a fan about Marc Aurelio and Lucius Annus Seneca. And as well, I like novels like Patricia Cornwell, Dan Brown, Michael Crichton. You know, I have all the bibliography about them. I love to read them.
Okay.
But never read a trade book. I'm sorry.
Okay, no, that's good to hear. I guess you got a lot of experience in the banks and you don't need the books, right?
I would like to write, but I'm not a good writer, you know.
Uh-huh.
But so
okay,
was just a thing. Okay.
Yeah.
Sorry, I interrupted you.
No, that's okay. No problem. Okay. So, what do you like to do when you're not trading?
Well, when I'm not trading, I like to do nothing. No, it's a joke. I'm joking. Well, I used to. Three times for weeks, I used to go in a gym club for a workout.
Mm-hmm.
I love to read, and as well, and this is a secret, I am 53 years, but I love to use the PlayStation.
Oh, wow.
So, I am a Resident Evil fan.
Nice. You know?
that's a secret. That's the keys. Inside the trader.
I see. Does that keep you from taking bad trades?
They make it better.
Yeah. Okay. Do you do any kind of meditation? This is something I always wonder.
Mm.
Or prayer or anything like that?
No. Meditation. No. At the end of the day, just my good meditation is. A glass of Jack Daniels, you know.
Nice. That's
my style of meditation.
It sounds good to me.
Yeah. I used to drink at the end of the day.
Mm-hmm.
My favorite Jack Daniels.
Oh, okay.
So,
how has trading changed your lifestyle? What would the trading lifestyle be to you?
Make it better.
How has Forex changed your lifestyle?
Well, that's a good question. It's difficult because I can say my Forex life changed completely. My life is a Forex,
mm-hmm.
and Forex is my life. It's all I have done all my life.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, as a job, because it is a passion, first of all.
Mm-hmm.
I have the passion to for a Forex like the first day. Maybe
nice.
the wisdom of the madness, probably, as I used to say.
Yeah.
But, of course, I am smart more than a normal people. As a trader, I'm smart. Yes, a smart snapper for everything. Sometimes when I speak with people,
mm-hmm.
or better say, when the people speak to me, I understand where they want to go before then they finish to tell me.
Mm-hmm.
Probably because you is a good exercise for your mind, still always on top, you know, mm-hmm. always ready for the action, then quiet, then ready again, then quiet. That's the typical a lot of I know a lot of person that prefer to stop. Then they retire. When they retire, they say no more Forex. And I still do Forex. And I can tell you, okay, I'm ready to go tomorrow or now in the dealing room. Mm-hmm. I'm ready. Mm-hmm. It's just a dream because I'm too old, you know. But that's my mind is always attention. It's more than me. I have no problem to focus it. Sometime, maybe two or three times per year, might be a day that I have a problem of concentration because. So what are you gonna do? I stop immediately, close my platform, mm-hmm. and get out mm. for a walk. Stop for the day.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes, better.
Like a mental stop loss. Yeah. Okay. That's a great answer. So if people want to find out more about you, you obviously have a lot to share. What's the best place to find you online?
Oh, well, I thank you very much for this question, but I don't think it's to be so famous that there is a memory zone on the web about me. After all, I'm only trader, but if someone wants to find more about me, can direct to find me on Twitter.
Okay.
I'm ready to speak with everyone. It's a pleasure for me.
Okay, great. Well, it's a pleasure to interview you. I really learned a lot, and I appreciate you taking up the time.
I thank you very much for your time. And let me know when when the interview is ready, if it is interesting or not. But okay. If you edit my interview, let me know when.
Yeah, okay. Sounds good. I'll let you know. Okay.
Okay.
Thanks, Walter.
Thank you very much. Okay, thank you, and have a great day.
Thanks, you too.
Thank you for listening to the Trading Lifestyle Podcast. To listen to all of the other episodes and get free access to Forex trading tools, tutorials, and resources, visit tradingheroes.com.